So recently, I was made aware of a video that Christina Hoff Sommers made. This video is probably from a while back, but she basically described herself as a freedom feminist or equity feminist. Basically, feminism to her was about being a free, independent, self-determining being or a woman. This was the type of feminism that I subscribed myself to when I was a feminist. And even today, there are feminists who are against this so-called third wave or whatever wave you want to call it, feminism, where it's essentially becoming about women whining that men are not doing enough for them and basically blaming everything on men and, drinking male tears while they're at it. Well, I have to tell you with all due honesty that sorry, if you truly understand the issues regarding gender at a deeper level, you cannot be a feminist in any shape or form. Or the best you can be is you can wear that term like a meaningless Girl Scout badge. And I'll tell you why. So let me start by explaining what is actually considered a woman's liberation. Essentially, it's to tell the society that you're your own master and you no longer have to obey your lord husband, and you can work, you can vote, you can provide for yourself and become what you want to become in life. That sounds great, right? Except society is made of people, including you. And society is made up of people's desires. If you are a heterosexual woman, most likely you want to fall in love and you want to find a man who suits you. Most women dream of a Jane Austen relationship. You know, Jane Austen was supposed to be one of the feminists in the 18th century, whatnot. This guy that you dream of, it's somebody like in a Jane Austen novel. He has shitloads of money, but he somehow just magically possesses those money, from inheritances. He doesn't actually have to work for them, he didn't actually earn them, and he falls in love with you. But he still lets you work, you can still work if you want to, and you can do whatever you want. And occasionally, you let him buy you nice things, jewelries or whatnot, clothes for your birthday, and you live in his house, which he inherited, which in your mind means that he doesn't actually really need to worry about too much about losing the house or even really have to pay anything for it because he inherited, which means in your mind that you don't have to pay anything to live in his house either. And he loves you very, very much, and he appreciates all your Elizabeth Bennet verbosity and vocabulary every single moment of your life, and you live happily ever after. Now, I'm not saying that this kind of fantasy has never, ever, ever happened in real life. Maybe it has. It's just about as rare as winning the lottery, maybe even rare. The truth of the matter is, when you're really out in society, you can have all the laws in your favor, but you still cannot be truly liberated from your own biology and your own desires. You, as a woman, will never be happy and feel free when you're constrained by your biology and you're constrained by the biology of men. Men, on the other hand, they fantasize about having a feminine woman. They want a woman who gives them the essential womanly things, which will inevitably be something close to being a housewife, a woman who is good at taking care of the children and him. If possible, she can cook, she can clean, she's good in bed. That's kind of the woman that he's attracted to. It sounds terrible in your ear, right? As a feminist, you want to liberate men from this kind of thinking. You say that this is just regressive, traditional, it limits the freedom of women because, you know, somehow your fantasy isn't actually regressive, traditional, and limits the freedom of women or men, but whatever, this is what you convince yourself of. You may sincerely believe that you are perfectly fine with a guy who has no money, no possessions, but let's say he fills the role of the house husband while you provide for him. And this is where the rabbit hole appears. If you happen to be a lucky heiress who has inherited a shitload of money and you still hold to these principles, you can live such a life with a man. You know, a man who will not work or who just work for himself and be the house husband for you. So in that situation, you can be a feminist in practice, but really, you didn't actually get the money from your own accomplishments or your own work. So that definitely would go against what is supposed to mean to be a strong woman, a strong independent woman and a feminist, right? It's not strong by any means, it's not independent by any means, you just have what you have because you happen to have the privilege. If, however, you don't have that privilege, like 99% of the women, then you have to work. Now, you then might say, yes, I can work and provide for the family. That's great. Well, try. I can tell you from my own experience that very few women manage to accomplish this and live the life they dream of, which is a nice middle class or upper lifestyle with a nice house and you have plenty of nice things and you take vacations, you know, that kind of thing. In order to be the financial provider of the household, you probably have to get a job, you know, in modern society as, let's say, a programmer, or you might have to be an engineer. Something that many men ended up being, because these are the jobs that are the most marketable. They have many positions because this is what's in demand. Now, at first, it sounds nice to you because those jobs do suggest status until you actually get the freaking job. Let's just say that there's a reason why most programmers and engineers are men. Now, I'm not going to say that women are dumb or whatever to be a good programmer and engineer. I'm simply going to say that it's one of those jobs that sucks the living soul out of you. They are mechanic jobs, devoid of any humanity or emotion, and they will bore you to death while they frustrate the living shit out of you because you basically ended up making numbers and symbols as your life. My mother is one of these programmers. She's a software engineer. She's a tester. And I don't even know how she keeps it up because she's gotten to the point where she feels paralysis in her face, basically. Decades of doing such a job for her has driven her half mad, really. The money really is her only source of comfort and her only source of sanity. My mother was a very attractive woman in her youth. And, you know, attractiveness, it's something very important to women, especially. I mean, to men too, but especially to women. And being a programmer for decades has greatly accelerated both her aging and her disfiguration from fatigue and damaging in her immune system. So in order to keep going, my mother has to take care of her own health on top of being a housewife and take care of her husband, my dad, with both of which, ironically, she enjoys. She enjoys being a housewife because it's something that takes her mind off of being a programmer. And she's good at it, so she really now just has two jobs, which, you know, in some ways she willingly take because it keeps her sane. So is this really the kind of life that you want? Is this your liberation that you dreamt of? Most women chose otherwise. No, it's not patriarchy. They chose otherwise once they realized just how shitty these jobs are. to just give a real life example, there was once that my advisor made all of his students take a programming class, all of whom are women, I believe. Yes. And all of the women who don't have any kind of support from, you know, in their life, for example, like a husband or boyfriend or whatever, a tutor who can help them with homework, all those women who don't have that, they ended up dropping the class after just 2 weeks. Yeah, and my advisor was pretty upset about that, but, you know, he can't force them to stay in the class, right? I mean, that's patriarchy for you darlings. Now, at this point, I know that many of you will be offended and you will do the special pleading like, there are plenty of programmers and engineers and they're very, very, very happy with their jobs. Well, as I pointed out, it takes a certain mindset to be able to love being either one of those as your life job. You know, again, most women in their mind, they think about jobs just as some kind of a side thing, right? You know, sometimes, oh, I get plenty of money and I get to do what I want. But actually, your job basically becomes your life. That's just what men go through on a daily basis. Basically, this means that if you're one of them, if you're one of those female programmers and engineers who actually end up loving your job, you're probably not very feminine. I'm sorry, this is just, you know, statistically speaking, you're probably not one of those very feminine women, which means that you're not going to be attractive to most men whom you find attractive, because most women like masculine men. You know, just look at all the movies, right? Or maybe you're one of those women who like more feminine men, but those men you find attractive will be very, very few. So again, this is just another lottery-hitting scenario. You're free to try, but don't say I didn't warn you. But you may be an honest person and you admit that, yeah, I mean, you really don't want to be a programmer or engineer or any of those mechanic office jobs that men, you know, have to take, you know, almost all the time. You say that, whatever, I don't have to be one of those and I can still be at least half the contributor to the financial situation in my household. Or let's just say that you just work for yourself. You don't get married, you don't have any kind of dependents, you know, you just pretty much be alone for the rest of your life. Sure, just keep in mind that most likely you will not live the life you want. You know, again, this is just statistics. You will not get to buy fancy things that you like to buy. You will not to eat at fancy restaurants or go to a fancy opera or play or have a fancy wedding or vacation that you dreamed of, a honeymoon that you dreamed of. Because most likely, your job is not going to pay as much as a job that a man commonly does. But you hate. You will most likely have a lower household income than those women who ended up marrying a man who's much richer than they are. So, what is your liberation? Well, you're free to choose a miserable life. And in your misery, you still have feminism as your comfort, right? You can just blame men. Men who wear fancy suits out of their offices and make at least $70,000 a year, and working in that capitalist system that brought you nice things such as movies and iPhones and internet and computers and home facilities, you want to convince yourself that it's because most of these people who are working in these positions getting high pay are men, and you just got intimidated and you weren't helped as much as you deserve to be helped in order to make this job work for you. But really, at the end of the day, the truth of the matter is, you tried to be like them and you just couldn't. You tried to be yourself and you ended up miserable. So how have you liberated yourself?